Okay, we're doing a red wine reduction sauce. And in preparation of the red wine reduction sauce, we're making a stock. And this is a stock that we make all the time. This is the easiest thing in the world. I go to the market and buy really inexpensive meat. This is a beef bone, beef neck bones and pork neck bones and some marrow bones. The marrow bones are nice because the marrow actually helps thicken the stock. And of course, the unbelievable flavors in there. And you can see they're well roasted under the broiler. And while I'm doing that, I prep the rest of the stock. It's basically a vegetable stock with meat in it. This is a parsnip, which seems like an unusual ingredient, but a parsnip adds sweetness to the stock.
Oh, really?
Yeah. You notice I didn't peel it. I don't peel anything. I washed it, but I didn't peel it. Yeah, onions, the skins and everything.
Well, it's all going to get strained. So.
It's all going to get strained. It all gets cooked. It gets sterilized.
Uh-huh. Yeah, who cares?
Whole head of garlic. Oh. Cut down the equator. A lot of carrots is good. It adds a lot of body to the stock. The rind from Parmesan cheese. You always save the rinds to go in the stock. Adds incredible mouthfeel. Some rosemary and oregano from the garden. Bunch of parsley.
Oh, he doesn't even chop that.
No, it cooks so long. Another secret ingredient. This is a dry Anaheim pepper. Because it's dried, it's got this Anaheim sweetness to it that's really great. So that's all the vegetables. What did I forget? I think I got it all in there.
Did you get your bay leaf in?
Bay leaf.
And a little basil. You didn't bring, you got some basil in here, don't you? So we collect all this wine. Now, you can make this without 100% wine. The more wine you use, the better it is.
Well, what'd you put in there? It looks like it's a Syrah. What's the...
it's everything.
This is a $500 stock.
If it's red, it goes in there. I put in about a tablespoon of salt. You know, the vegetables soak up a lot of salt. And it doesn't end up salty at all. If you try to salt it afterwards, it doesn't work as well. The meat goes in.
So it looks like 3 pounds of bones?
Yeah, about 3 pounds of bones. The beef bones and the neck bones worked really well. This actually didn't cook since last night, but you don't want to cook it too fast. What happens when you cook it too fast is it breaks up the fat and homogenizes the fat into the liquid, and you end up with a cloudy stock. And then you can't get it uncloudy. It's like homogenizing milk.
Yeah. So that was 100% wine?
That was 100% wine, yeah. I've got this colander into the sink. So that's the first straining. The second straining goes right in the top of the mason jar. That'll strain out all the rest of the solids. Then it goes in the refrigerator. While the stock is cooking, I don't do any skimming of fat off the top. You're gonna chill it in the refrigerator. And all the fat will rise to the top and solidify. And all the really fine solids that go through the little fine strain there will fall to the bottom. And you'll be left with clear stock in the middle. Get normally 6 quarts. We can cook it down a little bit to thicken it. And then from past stocks, I've got a little demi-glace. Now this was that same stock cooked down about five times, or 20% of its original volume. You just cook it down until it gets as strong as you want it to get. Mm-hmm. What we're going to do is when we make the sauce, we're going to thicken it with a little arrowroot at the end.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
Here, taste the demi-glace. Mm-hmm. Oh.
That's good.
Isn't that good?
And this is 100% wine as well?
Yeah.
Now this has been,
same stock.
Reduced to the nth degree, right?
Reduced to the nth degree. Actually, if you get any stronger than this, it gets too strong.
That's delicious.
And then, of course, that goes a long way. So actually, I'm going to use what's left in here, which is not quite enough for dinner. We're going to cook that down a little bit. Goes down. Once the fat's out of it, you can boil it down really quickly. You know, full on heat. Boil it down until it's about a cup. And then we'll throw this in, and then we'll take a little out. That'll give us our sauce for dinner. So we've made our stock. Normally this would have been in now for several days in the refrigerator. It'd be sitting in there just waiting for us to use it. The fat on top would actually be solidified. We'll cook down part of it. Left the solids behind at the bottom. Meanwhile, we'll see how our stock's doing. So we're gonna thicken that a little bit with some arrowroot. I like to use arrowroot instead of cornstarch because it has a much silkier consistency, and it actually thickens before it boils. Cornstarch you have to cook a while, otherwise it tastes kind of starchy. Then of course there's flour. You can use flour in flour is used for gravy. Starch is used for sauce. That's really the difference. Just use a little water to thin it out.
Oh, okay.
So it'll mix in. You need to really liquefy it before you mix it, otherwise you get lumps.
Yeah.
So, see, I cooked that down. That was like a half a quart. Now, if I'd made that the day before and I would cook down like, instead of making dinner like this, I cooked down like 4 quarts of it until it was like this. But I didn't, so we're gonna throw the demi-glace in.
Wow, oh, that's beautiful.
So I can put this back on the stove on a medium heat. And when it starts to thicken, it gets clear. So it's very easy to control. It loses, see it right now, it's cloudy.
Oh yeah. Huh.
And when it cooks, actually before it boils, it gets clear. If you reheat your stock and you bring it to a vigorous boil, it actually breaks it down. You have to add some more because it won't stay thick. And I'm not thickening it a lot. I'm just giving it a little texture, you know?
Pretty?
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Beautiful. See, because it's almost clear. Okay. It's ready to go.
All right.
Oh, look at that. Oh, that's beautiful. Oh. Looks delicious. Nice job.
I always put sauce on the plate before I plate, and then put sauce on the top, but you only cover the meat if you've overcooked it.
Beautiful. Very nice job.
Thank you. Mine is the 2002 DRX, which is our flagship Meritage blend, Bordeaux style. Another select program. So rather than being all from the same vineyard, it's from the best barrels in the cave from all the various lots. So we have like 4 Cabernet vineyards and 3 Merlot vineyards and 4 Cabernet Franc vineyards. So it's the best barrels. It's blended in the second year and goes back in the barrel for a third year. Bon appetit.
Bon appetit.
Cheers.
Thank you so much.
I expect you to go home and cook this now. You can do it.
Beautiful bouquet on this wine.
Thank you.
Oh, that's lovely.
Really nice.
Yeah. This was indeed memorable. Mm-hmm.